Hi guys and ladies, we are playing today the Siege Survival Gloria Victis game. This is the prologue as you can see, and the game is out since 18th May this year, so quite a while already. It was made by Black Eye Games Fish Tank Studio and the publisher is Ravenscourt. So let's try this out and see if we like it. It's all about a fortress, a kind of a town that was attacked. So it's all about scavenging inside of a castle, inside of the town's walls or the castle's walls. And you need to try to survive and get some resources to build up anything that you can again. 6th day of summer, year 1205, Kingdom of Midland. We were just starting harvest when the Ismir struck out of nowhere, catching us off guard. Horns of war sounded throughout Endring, and the smoke-filled city streets ran red with the blood of its citizens. The savage warriors from Kergald had invaded our home. Continue. The town guard fought bravely, but the Ismirs were too many. Before long, the raiders were in the main square and the city center stood in flames. All we could do was send a messenger out to summon aid while the outnumbered guards focused on protecting the workers salvaging supplies. The fleeing citizens? No, the workers salvaging supplies. Knowing the fate of the castle depends on food stocks, the guards gave their lives to help salvage as much as possible. Would the extra supplies help us survive the siege? It was up to the rest of us to ensure the sacrifice would not be squandered. Squandered, I guess. Don't know that word, sorry. The bloodshed continued unabated, street by street, square after square. The Ismirs overran the city, murdering anyone who didn't escape in time. Then they prepared their war engines, smashing the gate connecting the town and the castle. We thought things couldn't get any worse when we glimpsed up a mysterious figure. The barracks were destroyed. The barracks were destroyed. Anyone still able to carry a blade was ordered to ready themselves for defense of the bastion. Alas, a tremendous boulder crashed down onto the barracks. The ceiling collapsed, killing and wounding many men still trapped inside. Our defense would be that much weaker. We took shelter in the keep and took stock of the situation. Supplies were limited, no doubt, and Ismirs would soon attack again. The castle, the only part of Endring still uncaptured, was now under siege, and it was up to us to support our soldiers as they fight to stave off the enemy until relief comes. The bastion must hold. The prologue offers more than you'll see in just one playthrough. Depending on your choices, I couldn't read the rest. Move your character by clicking the left mouse button at the desired destination. You can move and rotate camera using the WASD and QE keys or the mouse. Now go to the man sitting by the castle wall and talk to him. Okay. Is he sitting? He's standing for me. How do I talk to him? Ah, you recognize the man before you. It's Bertram, a local carpenter. You are relieved to see he survived. It's clear, however, the events of the last day have scared him in some terrible way. He just sits there seemingly unaware of your presence, shivering and pressing his hand to his chest. Examine him. As you check him for wounds, you notice something in his tightly clenched hand. It's a small, scorched doll. You suddenly realize this man has just lost his family. There is nothing you can do for this kind of pain. Still, perhaps a warm meal might snap him out of this state of shock. However, the kitchen was destroyed by Ismir trebuchets. You'll have to build a fireplace first. With all the debris around, you will surely have no difficulty finding firewood and other useful materials. Okay. So this is the fireplace, I guess. Let's go and... Oh wait, maybe this is not the collect resources, okay. I thought it was a fireplace that just was burned out, but nope. Take all. We always take all, right? Can we maybe collect more? It seems. A storehouse. Build stump with sawhorse. Okay. Yeah, maybe we should do that then. Do we have the resources? No, we don't. Okay. Once you select the construction you want to build, you can see it. Its property on the right. Okay. Yeah, doesn't work yet because thank you, tutorial, but you know, we don't have the materials yet, it seems. Let's go back and really try to build something because maybe we still can. Okay, yeah, we could. They just didn't allow it before because I had to read the tutorial first. God, you again. This is where you can craft new items. Once you select the scheme for the item you want to craft, you can see its properties on the right. To confirm your selection, use the button below. Okay. Okay. Some scheme can use a few alternative ingredients. Vegetables instead of eggs, for example. You can change the ingredients to be used with the arrow at the top right corner of the ingredient slot. If you have enough materials, you can choose to craft more units of the item at once. Okay. Yeah, I saw the game already a while ago, before it came out, or when it came out, and thought immediately it's an interesting game. Was just not sure if I got the time to play it at all, to show it to you, because I had too many other games to play it first. Collecting resources, okay. But now I finally got the time for that. I'm really glad about this. Oh, it seems we can here store. Oh, that's a storage, it seems. Looks like it, at least. Take a look around if we can scavenge anymore. Oh, it does not really let me. Medicine, bandage. Can we maybe do a fireplace now? Okay, we can. Let's do that here. And then we should try to cook something. It's a really interesting concept, though. Make meals using the fireplace. Okay. Let's see. Okay, we got that, so we could cook the egg. Why not? Go and bring him the egg. Bertram is still exactly where you left him, shivering and pressing the tattered doll to his chest. His eyes stare absently, pain frozen on his face. It's as though his mind just cannot escape what must have been his darkest moment. Feed him. He barely notices your presence, but you manage to make him eat. Bite after bite, you can see life coming back into him. Finally, he puts down the empty bowl and falls asleep. It's safe to guess He hasn't once shut his eyes since yesterday. Let him rest. Bertram's recovery would be so much better if he had even a simple bed, which you could build with materials laying in the streets. The gate connecting the city to the castle is damaged, but you recall there's a secret passage leading to the city market. You could use it and look for some supplies under the cover of night. But wait a minute, who is that man standing by the gate leading to the bastion? Let's go to work. Talk to the soldier by the gate. Okay. Let's interact with him. The soldier standing before you is covered in blood, his eyes dim with exhaustion, the tunic on his armor torn to shreds. Only once he speaks to you recognize Galvik, an experienced garrison member known and liked by the citizens for his cordial attitude. He is stunned speechless by the loss of his aunt and nieces. Yet another blow falling on a man already exhausted, but there is no time to grieve. Ismias will attack soon, he says. We must resupply before it happens. Then he reveals that a group of soldiers is searching through the city as well, but they still haven't come back. That's why he needs your help. What do you need? We need arrows, he says. Quite a lot of them, of course. It would take days to craft them from scratch. But how about the Boyer's workshop in the city? That's our chance. Hooray, says Galvik. All our lives depend on you. He returns to the bastion. Okay. Scavenge the city. Can I? Oh yeah. Begin at night. Select your scavenging point. If I could maybe make that map a bit bigger, would be helpful. This is just explaining it. On the top right corner you can see the backpack of the selected character, okay? Each of them having a different number of slots available. Think about what items you would need during the scavenge and move them from your common supplies to the backpack. Torches, shovels and weapons would be your usual choice. A hint, you have one torch, it might be useful. Okay. Can we choose a point? Yeah, marketplace would be nice. How do I choose that? Can only go here, really? Selected passage, such scavenging, I don't know. You've entered the despoiled city below the castle. You can move faster by double clicking the left mouse button. But be warned, running is louder and this is a city under occupation. It is definitely a good idea to move careful and mind your surroundings. Can we also sneak? Didn't say that. Cannot go through here, okay. Did I just run? I didn't want to do that. I think I gotta go out here. There's someone I should be careful. Oh, I can interact with that guy? Oh, a hanged man. Oh my god. Glass, wood. I think we need cloth and wood for making a bed. Probably a smart idea. More clothes. and herbs.
Not really.
Taking those. Vegetables, yeah, we take those. I think that's important to have some food. Don't like to interact with anyone. During the siege, worth as much as a handful of stones. Yeah, no thank you. I take the wood instead. More herbs. Nope. Thanks, but no thanks. Materials, stone, clay, and pieces of iron. Scrap anything that can be useful in construction. Yeah, we probably should take those. And I think we got... No, maybe we don't have enough wood. Let's take it. Don't have that much wood. That guy. I always have to click on the icon to connect something, it seems. Fibers, very important. I take two more wood, that's good enough for now. Wait, didn't that stack? Yes, it did, okay. I will take with me. More fiber. Okay. How about this? Damaged light armor can be repaired at repair workshop. I don't think so. I find a better one? Yes, I will take it, but not a light one. That's probably not so useful. As night turns to day, your character is easily visible to enemies. Patrols will be sent to your location soon. And additionally, scavenging is exhausting work, and soon your character may not be able to run from the guards. Yeah, we will just pick this up and then we go back. Valuables, we don't need that. And then we take the wood with us because it's getting daylight, he said. And we should go back. Right? Take the meat. And then we should go back here. Yeah, we want to return before anything bad happens. The night was calm. This night was calm, but the enemy assault can come any day and we must prepare for it. We should use this chance to help the soldiers at the bastion. Start a new day. Okay. What can we craft? Nothing really. Let's see here. workbench, butcher's table. Butcher's table is always important too, but I need the workbench first. Okay, let's do that. Then we will cook the meat. Do I also have some health bar and stamina bar or whatever? I don't see that anywhere. Do I need to eat at all? I have no clue. Tired and thirsty. Okay, so where do we get some water? It's raining though, but that doesn't help me probably. I need to build a well or something like that. Let's see what we can build here. Is that crafting tools? Torch. Build a bundle of arrows. We don't have the materials for that. What do we do with the set of tools? Used for the basic building and crafting process. Can we do that? No, we can't. We need planks. Do we do planks here? Yeah, we do. Let's craft some. Yeah, the game is pretty interesting for people that love to craft and to build. That's for sure. And it's a kind of sneaky game, like a spy, you know? You have to sneak around all the time to find materials. So that makes the game also interesting. What did happen? Got sick by being soaked in the rain. Are you kidding me? Can we build something against us? Can we build a house or anything? I think so. A repair workshop. Any other problems? I think so. Clean water. Can we? Okay, we can drink there, that's good. And we are tired. We need to build a bed, but I don't know yet where and how to build that. We don't have the scheme for that. So what would we do? Is there anything else that we can use for crafting? Let's just talk to that guy. Maybe he can help us. It seems Bertram is feeling much better. The loss of the family has had a crushing impact on him that only time can fully heal. Nonetheless, finally the carpenter has recovered from shock and is ready to rejoin the fight. It was Flint, right? He asks. I remember you visiting my workshop once or twice with Galvik. Thank you for your help. Now we should take care of the animals and find fresh water. Bertram is right. Fresh water is paramount. In a stroke of bad luck, the castle well took a direct hit from the trebuchet. Still, maybe if you clear away the debris, you might repair it somehow. You've got to try. Okay. You can switch between characters with the tab key or by selecting them directly with left mouse button or by clicking their portraits in left bottom corner. You can order them to complete different tasks, but remember you need to take care of their needs. Okay. Each character has a different set of strengths, weaknesses, which determine what your survivor excels at or not. You can see these feats in the biography window along with the character's backstory. Okay, so if I click on him now, wait, now I'm on Bertram, right? Yeah, I am. So let's see what he can build here. Can he build any more than I can? No, he can't. But he could maybe get rid of the debris and recover here the bell. Is that possible? What's that? Bandage, okay. Mm-hmm. had some clean water even, and now we can rebuild the well. You removed the debris blocking the well, sadly to no avail. The well's base has been crushed by the trebuchet projectiles. The shaft itself is blocked and there's no way you could clear it out before dying of thirst. Perhaps you could find some portable water in the city market under the cover of darkness. It's risky, but it's the best chance you have. You have no choice. Okay, that's too bad. I would like to rebuild the well. Oh well. So do I need to... Wait, I can craft this? That's good. Do I need to go now with Bertram into the city, it seems? Clear the debris blocking the hen house. Here are our quests. I did not see that. The tired and wounded need proper rest. Construct a bed in the keep. Search the city at night for clear water. Yeah, how do I construct a bed? Can anyone tell me? Can I now maybe? Didn't I just do some tools? Are they in my inventory? Yeah. Set of tools used for basic building and crafting processes. I got no freaking clue what to do now, but the hen house is blocked, he said. It must be this one. I think it is. Look, you can scroll pretty close here. Yeah, we take that. And now we have chickens and might be able to produce eggs. That's already something positive, I guess. Night is coming. Okay. Yeah, we took some stupid stuff now, but hey. How do we go out? Night has come. Scavenge the city. Send the character outside. Oh, can we... Wait a second. Can we take both of them? No, only one. Okay, good to know. He said the other one is slightly sick. Can we maybe go out now? Cannot? Sleep on the ground? Oh, only this one can be sent out. Okay. And then. Wait, and the other one can sleep on... Oh, he does. Okay. Oh, good. Yeah. Start scavenging. Let's go again here to the city. The marketplace. Let's take a look around if we find any water also. Maybe we should this time interact here. Let's try. You found the boyar's workshop. Needless to say, the Ismirs have been here. The building has been scorched and looted. Its owner hangs from a nearby tree, a dozen arrows sticking from his body. As you gaze on the destruction, a chilling wind reminds you why you are here, to find arrows for soldiers. Only one way to find out. Step inside. You prowl through the devastated workshop, looking for the previous arrows among piles and broken parts and burnt out furniture. Time passes, but you can't find any. Just as you are about to give up, you spot a flash in the dark under a broken roof beam. Could it be? Yes, arrows for the bastion defenders. You try pulling them out, but they seem stuck under the broken beam. You pull and pull until they are all yours. Suddenly, the dislodged beam collapses on top of you with all its weight. Pain shoots through your whole body. It takes you ages to get free. As you leave the workshop, you see something changed. The boyar's corpse has been taken down. An old woman leans over the body in the shade of the tree. She's sobbing, exhausted, and you guess she must be his mother. She had risked her life to cut her son down and bury him in a shallow grave. The woman struggles to move him, but she hurts herself with the axe under his belt. Help her bury the corpse. The woman is startled to see you approach, but you see relief in her eyes as she realizes you want to help. Once the corpse is buried, she gives you a small sack and silently walks away into the dark. Okay. So, take all. And we got a few more arrows now. Now, question is, no, we have been there already before. Maybe we should now take a look at the barrel here, because we didn't do that last time. Yes, yes, I know, we need some rest. There's some water. And we go to this one too, and then we go back, no worries. Going to torture you too long. Take all. This one, and then we go. Can do this. Go back. Yes, we do need to. The enemy assault approaches. We must get ready for the worst. The enemies are prepared to attack, and we need to support our soldiers to help them stop the assault. Start a new day. Where is now that soldier? I think I go on bedroom now, and this guy really needs some rest. Hopefully we can give him... Wait, can he maybe build himself a bed now? Is he wounded? I'm not sure about this. He's just thirsty. Let's drink something. Okay, that should help him. And the other one. Oh, the siege is starting. Did I give my arrows to those guys? I'm not sure. The defenders do everything they can to defend the castle against the invaders. The items you provide them give them a light of hope. For survival, the arrangement of bars and number represents the distribution of forces in combat. After the battle is over, they will be refreshed and the battle summary will be displayed. Okay. Can he maybe lay down and sleep? How do I do that? I have no idea. Oh god. They are now shooting. I should go anywhere to the side. Yeah, did they get the arrows I brought? I'm not sure about that. I really am not sure at all. I hope so. And I really don't know how to lay down and sleep without a bed. Might not ever happen. So yeah guys, if that is interesting for you, I do think the game is really very nice. Oh no, finally he laid down. And yeah, you might wanna take a look at it. And play it yourself a bit. That might help deciding. I think it's quite some big demo because it was some gigabytes that they gave me here. For playing it, for trying it out. So you could play for quite a long time, I believe. That's not only for a few minutes or so. Glory to the fallen. We have survived this attack despite heavy losses, but the morale of our soldiers may break after another slaughter like this. Oof, soldiers fallen, two wounded. Okay. So, I'm going to call it a day for today. I hope you enjoyed it a bit. If you like to see more indie games like that, and just get aware that they exist, because that's why we are running here the channel, then you might want to subscribe to the channel. And other than that, I see you then next time. Bye bye.